finance me. Of course, according to that article in Newsweek magazine, did you read that? That a 40-year-old woman has a better chance of getting kidnapped by a terrorist than getting married? So I'm hanging out at the World Trade Center. Trying to meet a guy, you know. I hate getting older, though. I am not having fun being 40, you know what I mean? And the first thing that goes on women is the boobs, right? That's the first thing. I remember when my boobs, I'm telling you, oh my God, you could serve dinner off of them, you know what I mean? Now I lay down, my nipples look like Marty Feldman's eyes. Hey. There's nothing under my arm you need to be concerned about. Yeah, you men laugh. Wait, you get older, Hank and the twins hit the toilet water. That'll be a shock. See, doctors say stress kills men. Men say women kill men. Do you know what scientists have found out really kills men? I'm not making this up. Orgasms. They found out you men are only born with so many orgasms. That's right. Once they're gone, you're dead. That's why we fake them. And that's why we live longer than men do. All right, men, here's one for you. Here's where men really have it over women, losing weight, right, ladies? For us to lose 5 pounds, what do we have to do? Starve. You men have to take a shit and burp. And you wonder why we're so angry. Another big difference between men and women, men do not know how to look sexy. Did you ever notice that? Women know how to look sexy. It's just kind of innate with us, right? Men do not know how to look sexy. Oh, except when they're trying to pick you up. Then they know how to look sexy, right? They all do the same thing. First thing happens, that head starts bobbing. That eyebrow goes up. That mouth drops open. They think they look sexy. We think they look retarded. Look at nudity is different as men and women. For example, a man can be looking at a Playboy magazine and a woman will look at it, won't we? We'll go, honey, she's beautiful. Or look at her shoes, because they always got them cool-ass shoes on, don't they? Totally different story if, say, a woman's looking at, oh, Playgirl magazine has pictures of naked men in it, and we got a guy sitting next to us, and we go, honey, look at that guy. Isn't he gorgeous? Men always say the same thing. He's gay! Now, that isn't fair, is it? We don't walk down the street with you guys. You see a good-looking woman and go, wow, what a fox. We don't say, she's a lesbian. Because we know you men will go, really? Do you like her? And last but not least, men, learn this here tonight. Women are not turned on by the same things you are we, ladies? No! Men are very visual. They're turned on by things they see. Women are very auditory. We're turned on by things we hear. For example, a man sees a woman in a bathing suit, turns him on, right? Woman sees a man in a bathing suit, does not turn her on, unless she hears he has money. Thank you very much. You've been a lot of fun. Thank you.
I'm not sure if our next performer has a unique Canadian wit that's been sharpened by her time in New York, or if it's an edgy New York style tempered by a pastoral Canadian upbringing. Either way, she's wonderfully funny. Please welcome the star of the new primetime sitcom, Pride and Joy, Caroline Ray.
Thank you. Very exciting to be here in Aspen. The altitude is making me crazy. I'm so spacey. It's ruining my timing when I tell jokes. I was trying to tell a joke last night. I was like, knock? Knock whose? There. 8,000 feet below, that would have killed, okay? So I'm at that age, 30. Sorry, I have an ovary caught in my throat. Hold on. Got it. I'm at that age where all of my friends are having babies. You know, I don't have any, so everything I do in comparison seems very inconsequential. And all of these horror stories are like, Well, you know, I was in labor for 42 days, and I didn't use an epidural. I had the baby out in the woods, and now I'm back at work full-time and breastfeeding. And I'm like, I bought the cutest skirt. It's strange, though, because I'm constantly going to baby showers. Have you ever gone? They're the weirdest things in the world. Everyone brings a gift for someone who doesn't exist yet, okay? So I'm having a husband shower. And, oh yeah. Because that way, when he finally gets here, he'll feel so much more at home. Do you know what I mean? No, 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 you don't have to borrow a toothbrush. You got one at the shower. Yeah. It was from my mother. And, well, I'm sorry the jeans are too long. We thought you were going to be taller. I'm sorry about the books. We thought you were going to be smarter. I'm just glad you turned out to be a boy. Half the time, I am so happy being single, and then other times, I'm like one bad relationship away from being one of those women who has 30 cats. Do you know what I mean? Naming them after ex-boyfriends. Get off the couch, piece of shit. Come here. I am just like an ex-boyfriend. I couldn't remember his name. No. Every time I end a relationship, the man always says, you know, the exact same thing to me. I'm going back to my wife. No, I'm kidding. No, people always say the same thing when they end relationships. You know, let's still be friends. Yeah. That's like being freed from a kidnapper and saying, keep in touch. Hey, remember that torture, those feedings? Call me. All right. It's so sad, because it's always you're in love with someone, they're in love with someone else, they're not in love with someone. You know, it's this vicious circle. It's like we're all walking around with the wrong scripts. You know what I mean? Because it's always the total lurker who comes up to me, you know, Caroline, I really love you so much. I'm sorry, you're reading for the part of the friend. Yeah. Yeah. I'm sorry. Your character never gets laid. Okay. Thanks for coming in. All right. I had the nicest boyfriend for a while. He used to call me Cutie, which was short for chronic urinary tract infection. And, get out. So romantic, and... some couples have a song. We had a drink, cranberry juice, and... still cry every time I see ocean spray. But anyway, he was a big liar, though. Oh, my God, he was a big, huge liar. I think you can always tell when someone's gonna lie to you because they're male, and a little bit of a hint, and they're dating me. So, now you can always tell, because people get liar lips. Look closely, because their lips kind of go like this when they're lying. Have you noticed this? Absolutely. Like, he used to come home at 5 o'clock every morning, and I was like, are you seeing someone else? He's like, no, I got a paper route. I'm like, yeah, okay. You know who I really wish would lie to me? My managers. They're Australian. They are the bluntest, most tactless people in the world, but they're Australian, so I have that kind of up talk. Do you know what I mean? So everything, they go up at the end of a sentence, so it sounds really, really good. So I was like, yeah, listen, we were talking to the guy, and you didn't get the part. No. Yeah, you know what? They thought you were fat and stupid, so it looks like you got nothing. They're not doctors. Good news, cancer. So ridiculous. A place who knows more about American comedy than Australians. But anyway, my mother attempted to leave me a message on the machine today. Do your mothers know how the answering machine works? I don't know what my mother thinks the answering machine actually is, but she has no idea. When she leaves me a message on the machine, she sounds as if she's trapped inside the machine. It is the most desperate tone in her voice. Carol? Carol! Carol! Pick up! Are you there? I'm in the machine! So awful. But my father's actually even worse. He leaves me these messages. Tell her that her father called. And ask her to call me, please. I live with a small man in the box. Hey, anybody call? How was your day? All right. They're both insane, my parents. My mother calls and she goes, Carol, what's the finger that you use when you're really angry with someone? I go, the middle one, Mom. Did you use that one? No. But I think I got my point across. I have this horrible image of my mother now cut off in traffic. Oh, something in my eye? She gets her hair done every week, and when she gets it done, she looks like she's wearing an L.A. Rams helmet. Do you know what I mean? It's that very natural, enormous Margaret Thatcher-like hair. Tease it higher, bigger, biggest hair ever. But when she goes swimming, she has never gotten it wet in her entire life. Hey, kids, don't splash me. I just had my hair done. Hi, Betty. Darling swimsuit. Where'd you get that? Talbot's? It's precious. I'll see you at bridge. And all my friends' fathers are like lawyers and doctors by day and then just total alcoholics by night. Do you know the type? They get so drunk at parties they can't even speak. They just make childlike gestures, you know? You're like, hey, Mr. Black, how are you? I don't know what it means, but I think it's something sexual. And my mother, she's stuck in the 1950s. She always gives me the exact same advice, you know? I'll call her up and I go, Mommy, it's really scary living in New York. I don't know what to do. I can't pay my bills. She's like, darling, just put on a little lipstick. Okay, great. Creditors knocking at my door. We're here for the furniture. Oh, just a second, please. Are you gone yet? How nice are you? Too nice. Thank you so much. Good night.
Our next performer brings something very rare to the comedy stage, a true sense of warmth and sincerity. She's been billed as the first hearing-impaired comedian. But to us, she's just plain hysterical. Please welcome a veteran of The Tonight Show, Kathy Buckley.
Yes, it's true. I am hearing impaired. No, I am not deaf. I just don't listen for shit. When I was born Rh negative, and then a couple years later, I developed spina meningitis. Doctors told my family, quote, that I would be a slow learner and that I would not grow to be any taller than 5'2". And I was in a school for retardation for 2 years before they found out it was just a hearing loss, and they called me slow. My best friend was a little Oriental girl, and she was blind. I have no concept for what blindness means for my eyes or my life. But every day, we would have lunch together. She'd have these great barbecue beef sandwiches, and I'd have these boring peanut butter and jelly. So every day, we would exchange lunch. Now, what I didn't realize until I got older, she never saw me exchange those lunches. But then again, I never heard her bitch about it either. Now, some people think that my hearing impairment is a handicap. Me, whenever I'm with the Italian side of my family, we're talking a perfect gift here. Can you imagine a hearing impaired child who's just learning how to read lips and to be with a bunch of Italians whose mouths are going 80 miles an hour? My life dream was to open up my own Evelyn Wood speed lip reading class. And their hands, heaven only knows what their hands were saying. I myself was just learning sign language. I figured, well, maybe they're signing with a lisp. One of the first signs that I did learn as a child was good morning. And I gotta tell you, as a kid, I was so excited that I could communicate that the very next family reunion, I went up to everybody and I signed. Good morning. I guess you can say they're not morning people. Now, lip reading is my main source of communication, and I do have to go up to people sometimes and say, excuse me, but I do lip read, and I usually get this. Sorry. You ever try lip reading those Kung Fu movies? That'll fuck your eyes up. And I spent a good 13 years with some of the top speech therapists in this country just learning how to talk so people would understand me, and now they all think I'm from New York. My hearing impairment is not my handicap. Being sexually frustrated, now there's a handicap. I've not had a date in 3.5 years, and I don't know if it's because I haven't heard the phone ring or what. I can imagine what masturbation is like. I can only use one hand while the other one moans and groans. Do you guys know Howard Stern is? You do? Well, see, I didn't. See, I can't hear the radio. I can hear the music because I can feel the vibration of the music. But if somebody is talking on the radio, I don't understand what they're saying. So I'm hoping that Sony will come out with a radio with big floppy lips. Anyway, Howard Stern wanted to know who this deaf comic was. Apparently, he was trying to locate me through the radio. He got a hold of my agent. My agent called me up and said, Kathy, would you be willing to do an interview with Howard Stern? I go, yeah, sure. Is he a nice guy? I went to New York. I met Howard. The first thing that came out of my mouth was, whoa, who doesn't do your hair? This man asked me some of the most absurd questions that I actually thought I was lip reading wrong. He seemed very interested in your personal life. He kept asking me, are you dating? Who are you getting it on with? Are you married? I said, no, Howard, I'm deaf. I'm not dumb. He even asked me if I would date a man with a disability. I said, I'd consider going out with you. I kept waiting and waiting and waiting for him to play music, because I associate the radio with music. So I asked him, I said, when are you going to play music? He says, I don't play music. What do you do, Howard? He said, I talk. I said, how long do you talk for, Howard? He said, 4 hours. I said, you talk on the radio for 4 hours? People listen to you talk for 4 hours? I said, I now know why God made me deaf. You guys know what closed captioning is? For those of you who don't, you have to buy a device, hook it up to the TV, and on the bottom of the TV, everything that's being said on the TV will come up in little white letters. A man came up to me one time and said, you know, I always see in the TV guide closed captions, but I never see anything on my TV. I said, that's because only deaf people can see it. People ask me all the time, how do you wake up in the morning if you can't hear an alarm? We have a special alarm, it's called Shake Awake. You push in the time you want to wake up, put it underneath the pillow, and it'll vibrate the pillow. I said, screw that. I strapped that thing on my inner thigh. And I'm hitting that snooze button, honey. Every 8 minutes. I may not get anywhere on time, but when I get there, I'm smiling. You guys want to hear some good news? The good news is they did come out with hearing aids for my particular hearing loss, and I have been hearing new sounds now for the last 7 years. Thank you. Best to you, God. I have thanked God and every little Japanese man that crosses my path. This is the very first hearing aid in the whole world where the computer chips are actually inside the hearing aid. Guess where they made it? United States of America. The computer chips are designed by AT&T. Now they're charging me for every freaking word I hear. But I was so impressed with the device, I had to write a letter to the president of AT&T, Mr. Wakanaki. Sounds are incredible to me, but one of the first sounds that I did hear were the birds. And I tell you, I cried like a baby. I was walking down that street, and I heard that little bird, and I looked up into the tree, and I just said, damn. Birds are difficult to lip read. They've got these tiny little beaks. The one sound that really amazed me came from a parrot, a bird. It talked to me in English. That's pretty good considering it was in L.A. I was so amazed with this bird, I talked to it for half an hour. By the time I was done with this bird, it had a speech impediment. You guys have been a lot of fun. Have a good night, and God bless you all. Thank you.
Performer is simply delightful. She's witty, she's charming, and most of all, she's absolutely hilarious. Just ask Johnny Carson, Jay Leno, or David Letterman. She's had stand-up and standout performances on all of their shows. Wendy Liebman.
Thank you. How are you, Aspen? I am so happy to be here. I was just in Alaska. I know. I was there for 2 days and 14 nights. And it was so cold there, you guys. I saw a dog wearing a cat. And I was, I was flying here, right? And there was a guy sitting next to me, and I could tell he really wanted me to shut up. And I could tell that. You know how I could tell? Because he kept going, shut up. Because I'm like chatting. He's busy, you know, trying to fly the plane. And he's like very, very focused on that bottle of vodka. And he was like very, very drunk. You know those little bottles that cost $4 unless you steal them off the cart as it rolls over your foot. And the flight attendant, what can I say about her? She was a bitch. And she had, I'm sorry, I meant that. And she had, I'm just jealous because she had a gorgeous body, like an hourglass figure, you know. And I have an hour and a half. I have too much time on my ass. I have not enough at 2 and 10 o'clock. And I mean it. Or is it 1 and 11? I guess it depends on how perky you are. I'm a digital. I'm very, very flat. These aren't mine. I wear the 18-hour bra in 15 minutes. And what I stuff my bra. I do. So if you get to second base with me, you'll find that the bases are loaded. But then, then you're out. Sliding home. And I'd never get implants, but I did have plastic surgery. They took away all my credit cards. And except my Discover card, they left that one. They said nobody takes that one anyway. Except Sears. And who shops there? I do. And I bought a tractor. And I feel like it's an impulse buy. I got my dress at Sears. And these aren't shoulder pads, if you're wondering. They're maxi pads. And they are like, I feel fashionable and fresh. And I feel like they have wings and everything. And they're so, like, the women knew what I meant by that, right? Right? And some of the guys. And now I always wear maxi pads. I do. I don't always wear always. I sometimes wear always. It depends. I sometimes wear. I love you. That was spiritual, wasn't it? Maybe it was the altitude. I don't know. I've been getting really spiritual. I call the psychic friend hotline. The woman goes, I see in your future a really big phone bill. And how come they couldn't predict the thing like the earthquake? Like, were you there in Los Angeles? Can I just say one thing about that earthquake? Fuck. And I... So I wish my boyfriend were here in Aspen, but I don't have one. I don't have details. My last boyfriend and I were really incompatible. Like, for an example, I'm a night person, and he didn't like me. And we were... And he reminded me of my father. Like, ever date somebody like your parent? Like, he was a little overweight and balding and married. And he was like... I would never do that again. I would never. How many of you are married? Let me hear a round of applause. Married people at the Wheeler. Are you? I was married. They say the secret to a successful marriage is don't go to bed angry. So I was awake for 2 years, and I was very tired. And it was a messy divorce because there was a baby involved, him. And I didn't want custody. I want a sensitive man now. I want a sensitive man, right, ladies? A man who will cry when I hit him. I want, like... No, I'd never hit a man if he were awake. Actually, younger guys have been approaching me lately and asking me to buy them alcohol, and I am... So, Colorado, I love the zoo in Denver. I love the zoo. I love the monkeys. Aren't they cute? Those are my favorite. And my least favorite are the, with the little heads, the kids. Those, always screaming and shitting, and they're kind of, like kids. No, kids are cute. I think I'd be a good mother. I've been called one. I think I would be, like, really overprotective. Like, I would never let the kid out of my body. Like, I would never do that. And I babysit for my best friend's two-year-old, and she comes over and I have to childproof the house. You know, I have to lock her out. And then we watch Barney does Dallas. And we do that. And I hate that fucking dinosaur. I don't care. He loves me. It's not mutual. I loved being a kid. I was really fat, though, and my parents used to stuff me with all this candy. It was great. I loved it. I don't think they wanted a child. I think they wanted a piñata. I hated that stick. I would be like... These are jokes. I love my parents. They always sent me to Camp Pendleton, and they actually... My mom is a ventriloquist, like she could throw her voice. So for 10 years, I thought the dog was telling me to kill my father. I got my brother to do it. But they are like, they're so proud of me because I used to be a secretary. I hated that so much. One day I just called in dead, you know, and they couldn't tell the difference. And like a lot of secretaries, I practically ran the company into the ground. And I would spend... all day just filing my nails. And I hated my boss. She was so mean, so I would call in sick a lot. I'd say I have female problems, right? And she didn't know that I meant her. Like, she was the problem. And after that job, I drove a taxi. Do I look like the type? Nah. I didn't pick people up. I just really needed a car. I was desperate. Now I have a car. It's a piece of junk, though. The kickstand's falling off. It's very, very, the airbag is manual. And I tried to spruce it up, and somebody eggs my car. Has that happened to you? Like, they cracked two eggs on the roof of my car. And I'm like, what? Is that my car on drugs? Like, what is that? Any questions? I don't do drugs, because I saw what they did to my friends. Because I'd get stoned, and they look really weird to me. So I